What's up, Edwins? What's up, Edwins? Afro Joe the Wookiee here telling you, Mortal is Wookiee Mafia. I guess everybody's gonna talk about it. Scares talked about it. Drama Alert talked about it. Keemstar. And I'm gonna talk about it. And it's like, look. I said I've actually done videos about Jake Paul and all like that. And I've actually put my 2 cents in it just to see what. Put my 2 cents in it and said what I said. And to be honest, it's like this, man. I was like, I still don't get it. This guy is supposed to be the face of YouTube. This guy is supposed to be everybody wants to be him and his brother. So, and they come up with a accusation. Well, Jake Paul's assistant comes out with accusations that Banks put his hands on her. To me, it sounds crooked because he's done everything. He actually has actually got is getting sued. What is he getting sued by his neighbors? And to me, it's like he's sitting up there and his assistant saying he's that Banks put hands on her. But there's witnesses coming out saying Banks didn't do nothing. He was just sitting at his table, I think with rice gum or something like that. I want to say rice gum, but I'm sorry, I might be wrong. But that Banks has been sitting at a table minding his business, having a good time. And all these witnesses are coming out saying the same thing. Banks was not bothering nobody. Only this Max character, they're saying this Max person keeps popping up. This Max person. Every time somebody does a video, Keemstar, Scares, or Philip DeFranco, this Max person comes up constantly. He says, "Well, I own Team 10, but don't tell Jake Paul." And it's coming to the point where he's losing subscribers. He hit 10 million, then he started losing it. Same with his brother, Logan Paul. Logan Paul has stuck his neck out for his brother. And what happened? Logan Paul's losing subscribers. The funny thing, Logan Paul's losing subscribers. Funny thing about it is that Logan Paul set up there and said, "Oh, low gangsters, don't forget to subscribe." You're telling people don't forget to subscribe, but you sent up there, put up a video up on Twitter saying, "Oh, if I lose subscribers, deuces." I was like, hold on. Why would you say deuces, but you still keep putting in your videos on YouTube that you want subscribers? Which is it, you want them or not? See, this is this is why I say people look up to the wrong people on YouTube. I said every time somebody that gets well known on YouTube, that power goes to their head and they think they can't be touched. They act like they can't be touched. And that's the sad part. And you see how this boy, Jake Paul, said they had a good job. Had a good job working with Disney. I'm sorry, working at Disney, making good money. See, if I got a job like that, why would I come back to YouTube? Not to be mean to everybody else or myself, but if you get a job like Disney, YouTube is nothing but chump change. If you got a job at a big network like Disney, aka Disney slash ABC, Disney slash Free Family. You're making good money. YouTube is chump change. Why would you lose that? See that, like they say, the actions that you do affects everybody around you. Didn't Jake's people on Team 10 start losing subscribers? His brother started losing subscribers. Everybody he knows is losing subscribers. And then what happened? That Violet girl, you seen Logan Paul's video or Jake Paul's video, that they called Jake Paul's ex-girlfriend Violet, I guess her name Violet, and she got said it on cam that he never hit her, he never spit on her or nothing. But he actually said in the video it was the opposite. It was the opposite. She was doing that to me. She was cheating on me. She was beating on me. She was spitting on me, calling me names. To me, how can we tell? I said, for one, to be honest, how do we know that was actually her on that phone? Because it could have been anybody on that phone. Two, how can I believe what he says? How can I believe anything this boy says? Now, his brother Logan Paul has a good image. Yeah, he's got evicted from two apartments. That's because he didn't. That's because he's been smashing place and sending merchandise to his fans, but he didn't burn down a house. He ain't burned down a house or nothing like his brother. But unless, like I said, how can we trust this man? Him and his assistant, because she sits up and says, "Well, Banks choked me. Da 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 da. He was cheating on his girlfriend. Da 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 da." But all these witnesses are saying, "No, he never did that. He never did that." Why? To me, it's like, why is Jake Paul trying to convince the world that the sky is green, but the grass is blue? But Banks is saying the sky is blue and the grass is green. And he's got people backing him up saying the same thing. The sky is blue, the grass is green. That's one thing I can never figure out. Jake Paul have sat there and trying to convince the world that the sky is green, the grass is blue, and he's a god, that he can't be touched. Now, if the police, they say the police has got involved with it. And to me, it's like, if they got the tape, even the club is cooperating, right? Like, the club's like, "Hey, man, I want this to be done and all with. Here's the tape. Here you go. We give a statement, da da da." Banks didn't do nothing. It's just Jake Paul's making up the story. If the club is saying that, then Jake Paul's a fucking liar. And I feel bad for his brother, that his brother's gonna go through hell. So to me, it's like his people. I'm not hating on Logan Paul. I never have been, just because I do Wookiee Mafia. Wookiee Mafia's gonna take over Law Gangsters. Doesn't mean I hate this guy. I don't. It's just his brother I can't stand. Logan Paul always, like, for real, there's actually been people that does YouTube videos too, little smaller ones, that actually did videos with this dude. They've actually seen people, "Oh, Logan Paul, Logan Paul, be a Maverick," and they buying stuff. And they pretty much saying he is just as kind, he's just as nice in person as he is in a video. I don't know. I don't. I'm not. To me, I don't know. He's not in my neck of the woods. Second thing is, I don't know what happened at the club. I wasn't there. I didn't see it. I really can't say much about it, 'cause look, only thing I could do is give my opinion and tell what like a TI is. If Jake Paul is lying, if the tape shows that Banks was minding his business and it backs up the witness's statement, then Jake is looking at time in jail. For one, him and his assistant looking, well, mostly his assistant, because she's making a false statement on somebody else's character, saying that he's doing this and he's doing that. So that's actually a false statement. She can look at jail time for that. Two, if Jake is, well, I don't know if Jake could be associated with it. If he is, he can be looking at jail time. That means he will not be doing YouTube videos, making money off of it. To me, it's like his way. It's like every time somebody subscribed to this boy, anybody subscribed to him is wasting their time. Like, you gotta remember, man, when you out there in that limelight, man, you are a role model to kids, 'cause kids are eating YouTube up. And this is why it's getting harder and harder for us smaller YouTubers to make some money off of YouTube, because people like Jake Paul is screwing it up for everybody. It's gonna come to a point now that, since this is going on with the whole Rice Gum versus Team 10 and KSI and Killer Keemstar and Scares and Philip DeFranco and da 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 da, diggity booty ass, rapper the cake, jelly ass. It's gonna make it harder for the rest of us. Why do you fuck it up for everybody else? If I was saying what you mean, I said, think about it. look what happened to one guy, and he posted up something racist, not PewDiePie, but something racist. An advertisement saw that. What happened? They pulled. We lost money. It takes one dumbass just to fuck it up for everybody else. But not to. I'm not calling Logan Paul a dumbass, but like in this situation, it takes two dumbasses just to fuck it up. But like I said, I'm not hating on Logan Paul. It's just Jake Paul just causing the problem. And the more we sit up here and talk about him and all this and that, we give him more fame. The more we sit up here and give into his bullshit, it's like he's like a disease. He's like AIDS, something that you can't get rid of. He's like a cancer that you cannot get rid of because people are so fascinated by his ignorance. So it's okay for this boy to go around lying on people. What if this kid, what if Jake Paul actually raped somebody? What if he raped some female or molested some child? Will y'all still stick behind him? That's like the biggest question. Would y'all stick behind Jake Paul? If he raped a female or molested a child, would y'all still stand behind him? All because his assistant said Banks wrapped his arm. Hold on, like, hold on. She said Banks choked her. If he's been at the table, if he's been at a private table all night, how did he get from the table to you that's on the other side of the room and choke you out? That's gonna be somebody trying to leave a little comment. I know some dumbass gonna leave a comment. Well, he got up and walked over that. No. No, it's like this. How did he know that? That was Jake Paul's assistant. If they never met, and Banks never watched his Jake Paul's video, how did he know that's his that's Jake Paul's assistant? You can say that way somebody told him. No, how did he know? If he didn't know that was Jake Paul's assistant, how did he know to go up to him and do that? If he did it, because there's no way in hell that he would know that that's his assistant. And just choke her out. How did anybody know that? How did she said, well, she saw that was Banks choking her. How did you know when you looking at him upside down? See, the stuff that she's saying is fascinating to me. If they rely on Banks, see, they do that because they want to hurt Banks, because they don't like Banks. I never met Banks. I really can't say I like or dislike this man because I don't know this man. I really don't know him from a hole in the wall or nothing. Like I said, I watch Killer Keemstar and Scarce and Philip DeFranco. And one thing about it is, those are my three places I go listen to the news. It's like, all right, let me see where I can get this. A little bit of column A, a little bit of column B, a little bit of column C. Let's put this shit together. What do we get? The whole story. That's how I see it. That's how I see it. But I sit here and I look at it and say, how did this happen? How do like why is this like for real? Why is anybody fight? See, YouTube is getting to the point where YouTube ain't being YouTube. You see how many people are leaving? Because they can't make the money because the bullshit the dumbasses does, like Jake Paul. It makes it harder for smaller YouTubers to make money. It's unfair for us because we work so damn hard trying to prove to everybody and get subscribers that we can't even make a fucking dollar. See, to me, I thought I was smart enough to have a fucking 9-to-5 job. But on the other hand, you got to look at it like this. We are YouTubers just like everybody else. Just like Jake Paul and Logan Paul, Scarce and all, Rice Gum and all them. But when it comes down to it, when we trying to make money off of YouTube, we can't because they still raising the bar so high that we can't make a dime. And it is so unfair that these dumbasses can make a lot of money, But I can't make a fucking dime because they doing the dumbest shit, setting people houses on fire, raping little kids, raping some fucking female, beating the shit out of her. But when we trying to make a dime, we can't get it because we're not doing what they do. But didn't y'all sit up there and didn't YouTube just sit up there and say, well, this is what we cutting out, no cursing, no violence, none of that. But they allowed Jake Paul to burn down his house, to sit there and give people smoking inhalation in their house, put somebody's life in danger by sitting up there burning stuff in his backyard. He gets away with it, and he gets paid the big bucks. It's okay for him to do stupid, silly shit and hurt somebody, and he gets paid money for it. But if I did it, I get striped, I get banned, I get all this. It's discrimination in itself. It is discrimination in itself. So YouTube, you telling me it's okay for him to say, fuck everybody, I'm gonna kill you. But when I say something like that, you want to strike, take my money away, and all like that, that's discrimination. Doesn't matter what color I am, but that is discrimination towards the smaller YouTubers. We can't make a fucking dime because you allowed this asshole to get away with shit. I don't bleep my shit. I'm not gonna bleep my shit. I'm gonna be honest to my Padawans, to my Wookiee Mafia, because they know how I am. It's awfully funny that he can make money because he can do anything, any damn thing he wants. He can kill somebody and still get paid. If I did that, I'm in jail cell, get my ass poked out. He does it, he's sitting on YouTube making shit tons of money. And it's unfair that he can get away with shit, but I can't. That's just, like I said, that is discrimination. Tell me what you think down in the comment section. Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Tumblr, subscribe to my channel, see those. Subscribe to both my YouTube channels. Follow me. Don't forget to hit my like page on Facebook. It's down in the description box below. All that's down in the description box below. Tell me what you think down in the comment section. It's like I said, I'd rather be a Jedi than a fucking Sith Lord because, man, life's a bitch. Life's too short. Don't be a dumbass like Jake Paul because, man, you don't never know what's going on. I'm waiting for him to kill somebody or hurt somebody to the point that he's looking at fucking jail time. Even if he does, he'll still get people loving his ass. I'm waiting for China to come out and say, I was raped, molested by Jake Paul. It probably will happen sooner than you think. I don't know. I don't know. But, all right, y'all. Peace.